I would like to say that I was very fortunate in my life to have had parents who taught me the joy of giving, not the joy of taking. And they weren't just telling me about it. They were great philanthropists. So I really feel that I was very fortunate because I was able to see how they were happy because they helped. My father was one of the biggest philanthropists in Greece, and I'm very proud of him. And my mother was like a saint. They always help people. And when I asked my mother, what is happiness, mother? She says, happiness is when you give of yourself, the joy of giving. So I said, and what do you want me to be when I grow up? She says, I want one thing from you. I want you to be a good example in life. We don't have enough good examples. So I prayed to have an opportunity to give of myself. And God was very good to me, and he gave me Alexander and a great country. I love Serbia. I love our country. I love helping our people, regardless of religion or ethnic origin. These people are in my mind 24 hours a day. There's nothing I would not do for them. Old people, children, sick people, whatever the country needs. As long as I can keep going, I would like to keep helping. And that's what my mission is.
My wife and I, when we were living in London, we thought we should help our country, but everyone. That includes all ethnic groups, all religions. It was very important to be impartial. It was a tragedy what was going on. So she first started Lifeline in Chicago in 1993. She registered it there. Then the second one was in London, then New York, and then Athens. And all these lifelines contributed eventually to a foundation in Belgrade called Foundation Princess Catherine in 2001. And there were many charities that took place everywhere, mainly in the United States, because the beauty of the United States was if you contribute money, you can deduct it from your taxes. But we traveled a lot there, and we traveled all over Serbia, Republika Srpska, Montenegro, to many places, and it was desperate what we saw. We saw many problems. Problems with children, old people, lack of medicines, medical equipment, shocking situation. One third broken down, one third cannibalized, another third, which were functional, if you can call it, and the desperate need to replace this equipment.
When I realized that Serbia was having a serious situation, I felt the time has come to start Lifeline, to give a line of life to our country. So I started in Chicago 23 years ago by opening an office, Lifeline Chicago. And then after that, we went into New York, Toronto, Canada, London, United Kingdom, Athens, Greece, and then eventually I was blessed to open an office in Belgrade because we went to live there 15 years ago. So we have done a lot. We have gone from helping hospitals, which my husband and I have been to every hospital and every clinic in the entire country, with medical equipment, with ambulances, with everything you can imagine. For us, their problem was our problem. Their smiles were our smiles. And I never forgot how many tears I had to wipe and how much hope I gave to the people, because hope you cannot buy and you cannot just talk about it. Hope comes with action. And this is what my parents always taught me.
I've joined my wife on many trips across our country. And that involves going to hospitals and medical institutions. And we've seen some desperate situations. I remember the case of incubators, where you had premature babies being born, and the mother putting the baby close to her body and trying to find an incubator nearby or even far away. And by the time she found an incubator, the baby had died and things like that. And we'd heard these stories when we visited the hospitals. So she was determined to do something about that. And those were the good times in Greece. She organized a charity in the National Bank of Greece and raised 1 million euros. You're talking about 100 incubators there and to the main hospitals and the main cities. And then she managed to raise even more to get another 100. So it was absolutely spectacular. Sadly, the publicity, the knowledge of the work of Lifeline and Foundation Princess Catherine was not known, because we were still living a bit in the past. To be very blunt, we were censored. But the word went around that there was this princess doing something for the good of the people, for everyone. And that made one feel good. Things have got better now. We have a lot of media who really, put it bluntly, taken our side and understood how important it is to have a royal family that cares for the people, and not taking sides, not political sides, but helping everyone.
I'm looking forward to the 6th of February because I feel very proud of Zeli Marinkovic and Roxanda Ilicic, who have donated paintings and lovely fashion to help the children with special needs. And this is not the first time for either one. Both of them have been very generous and wonderful in the work I'm doing.
We're also very excited because we're going to be showing very famous fashion designer Roxanda and our very famous artist Zile. They are really renowned in the world, and they're not the only wonderful people that have come out of Serbia that have created something. We have Tesla, we have Pupin, we have a lot of brilliant minds here, and I think that everybody should come to Serbia, meet the people, see what we've created. Microsoft has 10 innovation centers in the world and one is here. When you help the children here, you're helping your future, because this future is people who can create something. Maybe they one day will create something to save a life or save your life. It's important to remember that we're all human, we all need help, and no one is born in this world alone. So that's why this event is important, not only for the money, but also for the awareness that it brings of this amazing country that really, when people visit, they come back again and again and again. I'm very proud of the people here. I'm very proud of my parents who have done so much to help the country. And I think that this event is going to be a big awareness, and hopefully we can have one every year.
Well, I'm very glad that we're having this charity next month, 6th of February, here, and very grateful to Zile Marinković and Roxana Ilicic. They're two great people who represent the really fantastic talent that we have at home in Serbia. And donating paintings, donating dresses, for the good cause of helping children. Children need a lot of help, particularly the disadvantaged children. We have a sad situation with disadvantaged children, and they need to be recognized, respected, and helped. So these two wonderful people coming to this charity and contributing what their talent is able of doing, I'm so grateful to that.
I pray every day that God gives me opportunities so I can help more and more. And God does give me opportunities. And now on February 6th, we have one more. A lovely cocktail party that will end up with a great auction. And I'm really looking forward to a very successful event. And I'm sure that Serbia is in the hearts of many people, and the children in particular. And I know together we can do it. You help me. I help you.